stay in that position.
I can email it to you, but I...
Do you do it to learn?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Turn your shoulder, look it down.
Okay. I kind of throw it early.
Yeah, that's all right.
I usually nail it.
You just go like, yeah, you just dip that shoulder and you go, yeah, looks good. I just look at the other option.
Okay.
Am I getting thrown next?
Yeah, my turn.
Go slow the first time, go wild.
So easy when you do it, right?
Yeah.
It is. A lot of times people struggle with it. And like, you see the...
Like, it's been a while.
So, don't worry about that, you just gotta keep doing it whether it's hard or not.
Clunked, yeah.
But it protects that around.
But I did, lay my knees together.
Oh, yes.
But it still was important to keep doing it, try to keep doing it.
Wait.
Am I tossing everybody now?
Well, it's your turn, right?
That is, I guess.
Yeah.
Unless you wanna be the dummy.
I slipped twice.
I threw it, I mean, he was the dummy the whole time.
Huh?
You can just go...
Is that too much over?
Okay.
It's okay. It's bring me in.
I love it.
Get a little more...
It's better in a turn.
Yeah, you hit the ground a little harder.
Yeah, but the actual throw is
more sideways.
You don't need the kick. Yeah, you don't need that kick. Like I said, there's some people that all the way through.
You turn that way.
Wait, can you turn in?
We've both gone through it now.
Yeah, it was a little more effort than last time.
Yeah.
Cause I wasn't getting...
Oh, serious, for my choice.
Yeah, it is.
You got to go.
Why am I...
One more thing to remember. This is...
Oh, I got it.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe more of a self-defense throw. But can you see like this happens? If I get my balance, you look yourself in the mirror. Right, so the self-defense part, if I can, you don't want to put yourself, but you might end up...
Pull you up like this?
Yeah.
I'm forcing you into decent technique. Otherwise, falling flat on your back. Great. See, now I've got... So when I take a throw, I have to focus on making sure I'm falling.
Oh, okay.
Come here.
So,
we're good.
Okay, real quick, guys, I want to point one thing out for self-defense purposes. You never want to put the arm on your shoulder around your neck.
Right.
Oh! Because he's... Yes, okay? But, for self-defense, you don't have to do that. Someone might actually do that to you in a self-defense situation. They grab you, immediately grab their arm, okay, right when you feel an arm go around your neck. See how I'm pulling here? And all I do is I drop to a knee, and that throws them very similar, okay? So,
you can do it standing too, right?
I'm going my tiptoes to regret that.
Yeah, so you might not attack me that way, but if you get attacked that way, though, chances are that if they do it quick enough,
right, if he's good at it, he knows what he's doing, he's immediately going to break my posture and choke me out.
Okay, so, but most people are very inexperienced. Immediately, when you train, you should reflexively, automatically, grab the arm, drop your weight, and pull. Okay? So, just remember, don't ever put yourself in that situation, but it is a proper throw if you get in that situation. That's the right thing to do. But you never want to enter it like that. Like, okay, choke me. Oh, to drop. Right?
I'm not going to... The things I can do.
Yeah, these can do a lot of stuff. You don't... It's more of a disadvantage, even though you could throw them. It's still more of a disadvantage for you. More of an advantage for the choker. Okay? So, but what you do to get out of that choke, that's one of the possibilities that might work. Might not. Okay? You guys got it? All right. So let's move on real quick. This one, I don't know if we need the mats. Yeah, I don't know if we need the mats unless it falls not that hard. Yeah, if someone wants to use them, it's fine. In fact, since it's a foot safe, it'll probably be easier on the hard surface. So, I do, and we'll work with you, Mark, because it's going to probably be like, I do need Bonsai Nage, right? Most of you Understand, yeah, he's going to step around. Most of you have done that foot sweep where we're on the side, right?
That's good.
We're on the side and I'm pushing the foot forward. And he falls, right? You guys have done that, right? Okay. Same idea. I think most of you have done this one as well. This is a combination. We're putting two throws together. Foot sweep with a... Okay? So I do your same magnet, it doesn't work. And immediately, keep a hold of this. Do not let it go. He just stepped right where I want him. I put my foot, the right foot, goes right behind, and I do the exact same thing. I pull it towards his, the direction of his toes. And as I do that, he's automatically going to go down because I'm pulling his weight to that foot. Does that make sense? So one more time real quick. This is the counter for him stepping around is the counter for being thrown with the foam semi-nugget. If you're quick, you can easily jump around. But if I'm anticipating that, I can easily get the foot sweep. Okay? So if I've got good timing, it's going to look like this. Where I don't have to do too much. I just hit that foot. And because he's trying to step down, I go automatically fall.
You're doing it before he...
Before he actually puts it down. Right? So kind of... Give me a good jump.
Okay.
So he jumps. I kind of catch it. You know, that was actually probably too good. So you see,
it was a good jump.
Good jump. But if you can catch it in the air right at the point where it comes down, where it hasn't quite put all his weight there, his weight's getting transferred. And if you pull that, it'll put itself on the ground without doing much work. But if he comes around, he's already. You're like, oh, and we're kind of stuck here. He's hanging on, and I'm hanging on. And I realize, right, his foot's there. I start at the bottom, and I lift, elevate up 45 degrees. Okay? I push it down, and I move it up slightly. I don't push it straight across, necessarily, because it's got a lot of weight on it. I kind of lift it up off the ground a little bit. Okay? Perfect throw, you want to sweep it right across. If I can do that, let's try it. If I can do that, great. And he'll fall. But sometimes our foot sticks, and you're like, better make your foot stick.
Sure.
Yeah. So it goes down, I gotta hit it, it sticks. All I gotta do is lift it, okay? So I'll lift it straight up and lift it 45 degrees. You guys understand? It'll come off the mat no matter what, alright? And remember this, there's the hard part. Remembering, I just hold on to this, because once I do that, I gotta pull his weight to that foot. Okay?
So you're using your body, you're not just using your hand, you're pulling with your...
I'm pulling with my body then. Yeah. Okay?
It doesn't match all that
right. So let's move to the side.
Yeah.
It's more clean up with 6 feet old.
Okay. Go ahead and work on that.
Okay,
so I'm
going to
throw you this way.
Okay. So
it's a combination.
You step around.
We're just going to go back to the
big
partner.
Yeah. So I'm going to get this foot. I'm going to pull that. Yeah, easy fall. Easy fall, right?
Yeah.
One more time.
Throwing you in the end.
Okay.
Okay.
You step around. That's all right. Yes.
I was trying to focus on stepping right.
Don't worry about it. I just want to be risky.
Yeah, the ball actually doesn't feel that weird. I can kind of hold on to too.
Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Exactly. And we're just going to control them.
I know, I did. Because I couldn't kick your foot out.
I did
the.
Nope.
Oh,
it's not easy for me either.
Step around. Put your foot right behind it. Now just pull it in the direction of my toes.
There you go.
Sorry. No, you're going to lose your balance at first. You're not used to this, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to teach you where to go after we get back down.
Yeah.
If you go down,
yeah.
You go magic
I was doing
it. That's right. Both guys go, just try not to put your knee in
there. Yeah, that's the big one. So.